Welcome to Remelations. We're your hosts.
I'm Mindy.
And I'm Brooke. Remelations is a dream interpretation podcast where we read listeners' dreams. From nightmares to the just plain bizarre, join us as we give you our comedic interpretation of your fucked up REM cycle.
This week, we're talking about really great Amazon deals. Baby kid gangs, watch out for them, and jewelry heist, real story, very creepy.
Yeah, very negative. We're also talking about buried treasure,
yes.
Night crawlers,
ew.
And Barbies.
I'm a Barbie girl.
In the Barbie world. We're also talking about discovering one of the most prolific serial killers in U.S. history.
Oh, no.
We're on the edge of our seats for this story.
All right, bestie. Let's get started.
Woo! Hi, Mindy.
Hey, girly.
How much fun did you have at our live show?
Oh, my God. It was so much fun. And thank you to every bestie that tuned in for that. That was a blast.
Thank you so much.
My God, I'm still having nightmares from all those dreams. Oh, my God. I had too many last night. I had the craziest dreams last night, and I blame it all on you. All on you,
well,
besties. You nailed it, though.
Fault. We're coming through with great, great nightmares.
And we have, there were so many dreams that we got submitted that we couldn't even read them all, which is going to give us so much great material for weeks to come.
Yeah, so you'll hear more and more.
Oh my gosh, yes. But
and I loved your costume.
Oh my God. You blew me away. I didn't expect it.
I know. Surprise, right?
Yeah, and hey, bestie, if you missed our live show, and you want to see the costumes and see it all live video, you go ahead and join our sleepover squad. Don't forget, and you can do that by going to remelations.com/support, and you get the whole behind the scenes fun of this week's episode.
That is a good one.
It was good. All right. Well, now we're back. It's November, which
now.
Is crazy. How is it already November? My God,
the
we are
fun
like
fun is over.
8 weeks from Christmas, 7 weeks. I don't know. It's insane.
Do you have your spreadsheet started for your Christmas gifts?
No, I don't, but I do have my mental list. So
okay.
I'll get there.
Well, you're starting.
I'm starting it. Yeah, now that we're past the spooky season, I can start concentrating on Christmas gifts by many children.
Many children.
Okay, this is catnap episode, so I'm going to start with one of my dreams. This is one I had just a couple weeks ago. Interesting. Okay. Funny twist, but weird.
That doesn't sound like
that doesn't
you
sound
at
like
all.
Me at all.
Okay.
It begins. I'm in a parking lot party of some type.
Fun.
I'm with my four daughters, but they're all much younger than they are today. So they're all like under the age of 10. They're little.
So a young parking lot party. Family friendly party.
You're right.
Yes.
Okay. There's some sort of family friend there, an older gentleman wearing a blue plaid shirt. I recognize him as a family friend, but I don't know who he is in real life.
Oh, boy.
Everyone liked him, but I had a very uneasy feeling about this guy, and I didn't want my kids anywhere near him.
You got to trust your instincts.
Mm-hmm.
It's bad, isn't it? Oh, I knew it's going to be bad.
Everyone kept telling me that he was harmless. He's just a friend of the family, but I couldn't shake the feeling that this guy had bad intentions. Okay, I look above the crowd and I realize where I am is a 5K and it's about to start.
Damn it. That's the worst part of the dream.
It's a party. It's a 5K party, Brooke. Sorry.
Can you drink or something?
Afterwards, you can. Which, by the way, like when Mark and I, we ran the Nashville Zoo, the Nashville 5K when we were in Nashville a few years ago, in 2020, right before the pandemic. Yeah. And the best part of it was we got a beer at the end.
I feel like that's the last thing I would want.
It was. It took a little bit. It took a little while before I was ready to process and drink that.
I was
going to
be like, I need water and rest.
And a banana.
Yeah, give me some potassium. Give me some something.
But yeah, no, 5Ks. Just last month was the Chicago Marathon, which is one of the biggest top five marathons of the world that people like run in to compete. I will not go downtown during the marathon, first of all.
No!
Traffic, awful. I will not do any session
awful.
Down there. It. Mm-hmm. I mean, people walk around with their medals and good for you. I mean, amazing. There. Did you hear how well the first female did in this race?
Mm-hmm. Is it like record setting?
She was 14 seconds away from making the record. which is crazy. God. 14 seconds for the female runner. Her name's Ruth Sheppen Gettish. And so she ran the marathon 14 seconds short of the record. So, okay. So if you come in first place, you get $75,000.
I was going to ask. I never knew like what a marathon gave you for winning.
One of those big ones. I just thought $75,000. Like, if you beat the record in the Chicago Marathon, you get a bonus of $75,000.
Double?
So she missed it by 14 seconds. My God, this woman's amazing.
Ruth, I'd be so upset. I mean, you accomplished such a great thing. I mean, don't be upset. But like, that's another 75
right?
grand.
Insane.
I think they should at least give her like
half of that.
40.
Right? She deserves it.
Can we prorate? She does this
every mile.
Get it, girl.
No shit.
Get it. That
Do you
great.
Have any guess of what she finished that that marathon in?
I have no clue what a marathon even
So 26 takes. Miles. How long do you think it would take a top athlete
Me?
To run?
48 hours.
I'll take a nap. I'll keep running some more. I'll take a
no,
nap.
No, that's just like me walking it. I don't know. Is like 6 hours good?
2 hours and 14 minutes.
What?
And some change. Like, I think like
so
18.
Someone finished in 2 hours?
26 miles. Yeah.
Like the record is like 2 hours?
Yeah.
Then?
Yeah. Yeah. So it was the equivalent of her running a 5K in 15 minutes, which is 3 miles. So 15, like five and a half minutes per mile. Like what?
That's amazing.
Insane.
Like, that's like what you can keep up for, like you said, like a few miles.
I can
right?
keep but that up for like 30 seconds. Maybe that's it. Ruth, hey, by the way, hashtag, yes? What is Ruth Sheppen Gettish dream?
Get
girl,
it, Ruth. Let
girl.
Us know. Woo!
And she could do that 5K in like no time at all. No time
I
at
mean,
all.
She, I don't know where she lives, but I bet she could come.
She could run us. Here. And hang out
she
with us really quickly.
Like 2 hours.
Yes.
Easily.
That's it.
2 hours.
2 hours.
No problem.
Insane.
No problem.
Anyways, so back to the dream. So it's a 5K. I mean,
yeah. Oh, yeah.
Again.
I forgot about, no offense. I forgot that's what we're, your dream.
Okay, so back to the dream. So it's a 5K going on. So all of a sudden, there's just chaos. Like everyone's trying to get to the starting line.
Oh, no.
I was getting bumped and pushed. Everyone's trying to shove past me. My kids kept getting further and further away from me, and I couldn't keep up with them. Like, they kept getting close to this creepy guy.
I was going to say, where's the
kid? Yeah, he's around the kids, and I just can't, and like, I can't catch up. Everyone's just in my way. Total stress.
Yeah, total stress dream.
All of a sudden, I couldn't see my kids at all.
Ugh.
However, I did spot a tall announcer's stand. Like, the kind they have at baseball games. Like,
right. Where you're like, I gotta get up on this platform.
If I get up there, I'd have a better chance of seeing my kids. And in my dream, this is what I was thinking, spying on this creep and recording any inappropriate actions he was doing to anyone in the crowd.
Wow, you had an agenda.
It's like I had
a
notebook with me or something. I'm like, I don't trust this guy in my dream. It was
so weird.
You were getting
stuff done.
So I walked to the announcer stand. There was no easy way to get into the stand.
Uh-oh.
Like, I have no idea how the announcers got up there because there was like no stairs or no
maybe they like
ladder
lifted them up, just set them on top.
I walk around to the backside of it and I see there's this long old rickety ramp, like a 12 inch wide just board that was
it
like
reminds me of like getting on some boats.
Oh yeah, you know, like a plank.
Just like this tiny little piece and it's all rocking and rolling.
Yep. That wasn't good. So the ramp was a few feet off the ground. So what I had to do is jump from this dumpster onto this ramp to get.
You're totally parkour.
I'm parkouring it, man. Mindy's parkour adventure.
We gotta
I
get
got it.
This filmed. I know you're filming Creepo, but I want to see this film of you.
So I get to the ramp. Again, this ramp is old and falling apart. So every step I make up it, I'm like, I have to like crawl. It's not like I'm walking up it. I'm got to like
Hands and knees it.
Hands and knees it. But every step crawl I took, it became more unattached from the little announcer booth at the top.
Oh, no.
Okay. So here's where it takes an interesting twist.
Because I have a feeling this is...
I have a picture for you tonight.
I knew you were going to... I'm like, this feels like a picture to
me. I have a picture for you. Okay.
Okay.
I hear the announcer announce the start of the race.
Okay, fine.
And then I hear a female start to sing.
Sing?
I look up to the top of the ramp, and I see Dolly Parton.
Oh, my God. A national treasure.
The queen.
God bless Dolly.
Why is she here at this...
I don't care. This 5K, this just turned into the best dream ever.
What made me dream this? I have no clue.
I don't know, but God, I mean, lucky you.
Okay.
Dolly's amazing.
As I climb closer and closer to Dolly up this ramp, every inch I take keeps jostling her on the back of this, like,
and
the announcer's
booth. And
she's
trying to sing?
Yeah, but she keeps singing.
Well,
she keeps singing.
Because she's a star. She's a pro. She's a pro.
She's a pro.
The show must go on, even though there's some rando crawling up a ramp. You just became the rando in the dream.
I'm the rando in the dream. I was trying to keep an eye out on my kids and see what this creepy dude's doing.
You're doing the right thing, Mindy.
But every step I take, it keeps jostling, and Dolly is about to fall off.
No.
And make it to the top. Okay. And make one more final move. And she begins to fall backwards off the booth.
If you kill Dolly Parton, I'll never forgive you. Did you? Oh, God, what's going to happen?
I grab her by her back just barely before she falls several floors to the cement concrete below.
Thank God. I was really nervous.
I'm holding on to this American legend with all my might.
You hold on, Mindy.
I would not let this happen, Dolly. But it's funny because in my dream, I'm thinking in my mind, I don't want to be the person that killed Dolly Parton.
Oh my God. You'd be
Could you imagine?
Forever.
I'd be hated.
You'd be
hated.
Like number one on the most wanted list.
The announcers finally notice all the commotion and turn around and lend a hand to help Dolly back up into the booth.
Well, good.
Dolly smiles at me.
Of course she does.
But at this point, I'm dangling off the ledge as myself.
But she's just smiling at you.
She smiles at me.
Like waving hi.
The announcers don't care. They don't care that I'm dangling for
Dolly
my life
saved.
Now.
Dolly's saved. They don't care about some rando.
They don't even notice now that the ramp has crashed to the ground and I'm just dangling there. No help.
Oh.
They just go on with their business and then I wake
jerks.
Up. I saved Dolly, though.
You saved Dolly. God bless you. I feel like if you had dreamed for like 1 minute longer, Dolly would have saved
I think you're right. Thank you
I
for
mean,
that.
I mean, there's no chance she would have left.
No, I don't think so. I think she'd be there.
She would have like saved a raccoon that was like hanging off the edge.
Of course she would have. The greatest.
The greatest. Legendary.
But that was interesting.
That was...
What made me dream that, Brooke? Do you have any idea?
Yes.
What the
I
hell?
Think happened? I don't know. Were you watching Steel Magnolias or something?
No. But I always think of Dolly because she's amazing. So
she is. What do you have a favorite Dolly song?
Oh, my God.
I mean, that's
wow.
a tough one. No, I shouldn't put you on the spot like
no,
that.
No. I mean, I love Jolene.
Jolene's my favorite.
But I do like my niece, Lexi. She does a great rendition of 9 to 5.
Oh, that's, I mean, classic.
But, I mean, you cannot go wrong with that song.
Islands in the Stream?
Oh, my God. That's Mark and my, that's our karaoke song, by the way.
Oh
Islands in the Stream.
I love Islands in the Stream.
We do it as a duet.
Oh, well, it is a duet.
Yeah, he's Kenny, I'm Dolly. Oh, well, next time you come around.
Next time I'm just
in
even
town.
Over there. I don't care
do
if
it.
We go out.
No,
if
that's
we're
our song.
At your house.
That's our duet karaoke song. That's it.
I want to see it. I need to see it.
I can do a good Dolly.
Good.
And I saved her ass.
Oh, I thought maybe you like reversed it.
That would
be
funny.
Interesting.
Right? I'm Kenny, Mark's Dolly.
Yes. Just...
Actually, Kenny Rogers came to the Dubuque County Fair.
He did? When?
When my sister Shannon was the fair manager at our county fair.
I don't think I was in Dubuque at this time.
No, you were not. I think you were living in Arizona.
Gone. Yeah, okay.
So this was probably 2003, 4, 5 in that area.
Yep.
The early 2000s. My sister was the county fair manager. And if you are from the Midwest, you know that the county fairs are a big,
that's like
big deal.
The key to the castle.
It is.
Being the county fair manager. I mean, and it really is.
The fact that she was the manager, we got to go backstage for a lot of cool acts. And one story, I don't know if I was at the Kenny show, but one story she said is, you know how every star has their riders?
Yes. What was it, his rider?
He wanted his shirt pressed.
That's it?
So Shannon ironed Kenny Rogers' shirt before his show.
God bless Shannon, but also Kenny, for someone who deserves so much more than just a pressed shirt, that's all he asked for. It makes my heart flutter.
I don't know if that's all he asked for, but that's all she had to do. But I mean, it's a pretty big job.
I mean, because he's such a giant person. No, I mean, it's just ironing.
He just wanted that collar perfect.
I mean, yeah. I feel
you have to go around the rhinestones. I don't know how it works.
Yeah, like how does it work? Maybe that's why it's so difficult. You got to get in there around
You steam it, maybe? You steam it?
I bet it's a steam job.
I bet it's a steam job. But man, who can't go wrong with Kenny and Dolly?
Kenny and Dolly. We got there tonight. We got to our happy place. We got to Kenny and Dolly. Hey. Before we forget,
yes,
you haven't shown me your drawing yet.
Oh, yes. Okay. All right. So here we go. I'm going to show you my drawing of Dolly Parton about falling off of the back of the announcer's booth. Are you ready for this?
I can't wait to see how you have portrayed her in your sketch.
Yeah, it's interesting. this is something, if you want to see this, you can join our sleepover squad and make sure you get all the great drawings, stick figure drawings from my brain.
Trust me, if it's only for that, you want to see these drawings. Oh, I see you crawling. I see you crawling up the ramp. Okay. All the people down below. Oh, she's singing. I see her microphone. It's so clear to me now. I love it. I love it.
The arrow shows she's falling off.
I see the arrow. Yep. I didn't realize it was an enclosed.
Yeah, the announcer booth was enclosed.
I just thought of it as like an open platform. So I'm glad you shared the picture because now I can see it.
Now it makes it a little better. Yeah, in my mind, that's how it works.
Oh, we need pictures sometimes. All the time. I love them. They're my fave.
But that's not all because tonight is catnaps.
Catnaps. I feel like we need to come up with like a...
Mark's going to come up with a jingle.
Yes, like a jingle.
Okay, I'm going to write this down. My husband has to come.
That's just a suggestion. You can tell him. Catnaps. Yep. I mean, I know he's the musician, but here are a few notes.
Just that note.
Just catnaps. Okay, before we get to our catnaps, yes. I know we all just love Mindy's dreams, but you guys have dreams too. Don't forget to submit them to us. All you have to do is go to remelations@gmail.com. This includes dreams, dream stories, catnaps. We want it all.
You walk out of your house in the middle of the night and murder someone. We want to know about it.
We won't judge.
No. We might turn into the cops.
The judge might judge. But we're not going to.
The judge might judge. But hey, we'll not read us. It. Breaking news.
remelations@gmail.com. Please and thank you. Submit your dreams and dream stories.
Woo! I stole your woo.
You stole my woo.
I get it. It feels like something has to go there.
Sometimes you just feel like you got a woo?
Yeah. Yeah, you got a woo.
Now you get it. Got a woo.
All right. Got a woo. That's got to be a t-shirt.
I was going to say that could be a t-shirt or just woo.
Okay. So catnaps. Yes. Yay, let's go.
I like that. Catnaps. Yes. That's how you said it. Yes.
Catnaps. Yes. Do you mind if I get started?
Do it.
Okay. Remember last week when we had that dream about being in the mall not getting the snake skin boots?
Of course I do. Yes. Okay. Devastating.
This one popped up in my inbox and then I thought it was perfect.
Okay.
Perfect. Okay. This one's from Momo and she's from Providence, Rhode Island.
Thanks, Momo.
I don't remember much, but I was walking around a mall and kept seeing guys left and right with the same bag as I had.
Oh, like purse?
Purse.
Okay.
I got to the top of an escalator and I was face to face with someone with the same bag wearing it.
Oh, this is upsetting.
I point to it and said, $20 on Amazon? And he's like, yeah, $20 on Amazon.
Aren't you proud to share your deals? I love to share
deals. Always.
Always. I'm like, this coat, $5. I'm so happy
These
to share.
These shoes, discount.
$5.
$5.
Everything's always. $5.
So my mom was with me and she rolled her eyes. And my mom was like, get better style, Mo. I'm like, there's nothing wrong with dudes with purses. Mm-mm. More should do it. And in reality, there are. And I really like it.
They should do it because I don't want to carry your stuff. If you don't have pocket room, too bad. So sad.
Agreed. What's wrong with a man satchel?
Bring your man purse, your merce.
Your merce.
There's totally nothing fine. Wrong with a satchel.
Mark holds on to mine half the time. It's fine.
You know, I did test the strength of my Michael Kors purse tonight because I had four White Claws in it.
You had four White Claws in your purse?
Well, I didn't bring the whole
Where
thing.
Are you going? And why do you
no,
have them in your
I'm coming
purse?
Here. I didn't bring the
You're going to your house.
The box up. So I just grabbed some.
Oh, yeah.
And I put them in my purse and I'm like, wow, this thing's really holding some weight. Good nice. Job, Michael. Good job, Michael. Men's purses?
Yes.
I know. Why can't you?
But the fact that her purse matched every other man's purse, I think is
I would be
very
a little
fantastic.
Upset because it's like, you do want to show off your purse. I mean, you also want to show off a deal. So I get the $20
You're a
purse
person. You are. A person's shoes, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you lean to that. I could care less.
I
on my purse and my shoes.
And that's fine. Like, I don't buy expensive shoes and I don't buy expensive purses, but I like both of them. And I wish
sure.
I could buy more, but I do have a couple nice purses and I always feel extra special when I have them. And yeah. I know that probably means like nothing to you. You're like, I'll take a Target bag.
No, mine's like, I have a Michael Kors purse. Don't get me wrong.
I meant like a Target bag, like plastic bag.
Oh, yeah.
Like just throw your
no,
ID
it's fine.
In there.
I don't know. I'm just, it's so funny because I've known people throughout my life that have been like purse people. Like
yes.
They need to have the $1,000 purses. And to me, it's like, I don't
the money.
Personally care. But good for you if you do. I know
yep.
There's plenty of people out there who that's a part of them and they like to show it up. So that's cool.
I like a cute purse, but usually mine are the $20 deal on Amazon. So I relate to this dream because it's like, Why?
I think that's the fun part, right? The $20 on Momo. We got it.
I mean, like we want to share our deals.
You do.
I mean, every once in a while I get a nice one, but then I'm always so worried. It's like, what's the point? If I'm worried to like set it down or scratch it or something, it's like, I like a nice purse gift. Mm-hmm. That's how I like them. Mm-hmm. Couple circles.
Yeah. This is the one I want. Circle it.
Works.
Got it. Okay. Do you have a catnap treat?
I do. This is Carly and she's from San Diego. I found a buried treasure, but I couldn't get the chest open. I didn't know what was inside, but I guess I just assumed it would be treasure.
Well, you'd think.
That's what you would think. But as I was finally getting the lid open, I panicked and thought, what if it isn't a treasure?
What if it's in a body?
But the lid fell open and the chest was full of gems and pearls and coins.
Wonderful.
Good, right? Woo! It totally brought me back to my childhood, like I was in the Goonies.
I would just bathe in it. Just bathe in all the gems and coins. Totally get it, yes.
The first thing I thought of, too, was Goonies. I was like, yes, roll around in it. I reached in and a huge snake jumped out.
Out.
I'm done. I'm out.
I'll leave the treasure there.
Out. Don't need it. Followed by what seemed like 100 other snakes.
No. Now there's more snakes?
No, I don't like this dream. Took a bad turn. A bad turn.
Why? Everything's so good. And then it went.
Nope.
The pendulum swung the other way.
It's not getting better. I'm just going to let you know it's not getting any better. The first snake was a spitting cobra. and it got me right in the eyes.
That's not good. I don't think spitting cobras in my eyes.
No spitting cobras right in the eyes.
There's no treasure worth that.
I screamed in pain and terror. Oh, I hate this part. Okay. I screamed in pain and terror as the snakes engulfed me. That's it.
Nope. Hate this dream on a scale from 1 to 10. It's a 10.
Nightmares? Yes.
Yeah. Don't like it.
On any level? Yes. If 10 is the worst.
Because it's a false sense of a good dream.
It's a trick.
It's a tricky dream. And then you go to evil snakes.
And I know there's lots of different meanings for snakes, but so many snakes. And then the last thing you remember is being like engulfed in them.
I think I just wake up in a cold sweat with that one. Mm-mm. Or a hot sweat.
Pass.
Just a sweat.
Just a sweat.
A sweaty
good old
sweat.
Yes, Carly. A good
just
old
put a
sweat
suit on before you go to bed, and you can lose like a lot of weight.
Yeah, with these dreams, you sure could.
You're just sweating out all the fat.
You wake up like 10 pounds lighter when you have these snake dreams.
God damn.
Ooh, well, thank you, Carly.
Thank you, but not thank you.
Yeah, thank you, but no thanks.
Okay. This next dream comes from Eva. I had this dream 34 years ago.
Holy moly.
And I still remember it.
That's almost as old as we are.
Thanks, Eva.
Plus 10. Minus 2.
Somewhere in that range.
I don't do math.
I had a typical anxiety dream where I was in a play and I forgot my lines.
Oh, yeah. That's a classic.
The director said, "Don't worry. Since the orchestra pit is so wide, the audience is so far away, just mumble something and they won't even know."
That's the worst director ever. Just mumble something. The theater's terrible. They can't hear you anyway.
The acoustics in here suck. Just whatever. Mm-mm. But the whole audience laughed at me.
Nice. Or in a good way?
No.
Oh.
Then my alarm went off. I hit snooze, but then fell back asleep. I had the exact same dream.
I love this.
But this time, when he told me to mumble, I said, "No, they'll laugh at me. I just had this dream." And then she woke up.
Literally. I love the fact that she learned from her first
exactly.
dream.
Isn't that hilarious?
That's amazing.
So good.
That's amazing.
Yes. I love that. Eva, thank you for sending it in.
Yes,
I love those ones where you can restart it, but you're like, no.
I mean,
I know how this turns
out.
I can't
do that, and it's like, but nope, not going to do it the same way again because she learned. That's awesome. You don't hear that very often.
No,
like sometimes they fall back asleep and dream the same
thing. But it stuck with her for 34 years. Like, that's the funny thing.
34 years. That's amazing. Okay, this next one's from Brett from Dubuque.
Is this your brother, Brett?
Maybe. Okay. It's short and sweet.
Uh-huh. I can't wait.
I had a dream where my dad, so
Papa
obviously my dad, I had a dream where my dad dug through the freezer to make dinner, which turned out to be night crawlers. He ate everything.
Well.
And that's it. I told you it was short.
We know about your family and your family Sunday dinner, so it's not surprising.
I'm not going this weekend. It's going to be night crawlers.
I'm out. I'm not a fish.
Out.
I'm out.
I don't care if you tempt me with caramel brownies. I'm not going.
I go for the caramel brownies. Don't get me wrong.
I already got some this week, though. My dad's so cute. He dropped them off at work for me.
Cookies a couple weeks ago, and now brownies.
I know, brownies.
He's the best.
I know. Isn't he the cutest?
He is the cutest. I love it.
He is so cute.
But don't, Papa, mm-mm.
Did I ever tell
night
you
crawlers?
I got in big
no.
trouble when I was a kid?
Why?
Because we had night crawlers in the fridge for fishing at the lake.
Yes. Okay. So, Bessie, if you don't know, which you probably don't, Brooks, the house you grew up in, the neighborhood you grew up in, had a lake in the middle of it. Like this little, I don't even know.
The whole neighborhood, not just the house.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. The house, the neighborhood that the Brookie grew up in was like all surrounding this lake, Lake Barrington.
Yes.
And you lived in the Barrington subdivision, and this little lake was in the middle, and
we
did a lot of swimming there.
We had a
little beach,
a lot of swimming,
a lot of fun.
Mm-hmm. We had a lot of good times down there.
And so,
but we had night crawlers because my dad would take me fishing. And back then, I didn't mind touching worms.
Oh, heck no.
Now I'm not such a huge fan. But I get it. But anyway, there were night crawlers in the fridge where you keep them. And I guess I had brought one of the neighbor girls over to show her the night crawlers. But when I opened it, I got scared and just threw it in the fridge and like we left.
You left.
And then my mom found all the night
crawlers.
There's
just night crawlers like, crawling around her fridge.
The fridge. It was so gross.
As an adult, aren't you just so completely horrified by this story?
I'm so skeeved out right now by this story.
How old were you? But, would you say you were?
I would say probably, I'll verify with her because she remembers
herself. Oh, I'm sure she does.
But I would say maybe 7. Yeah, where I'm like, hey, come check out these worms.
Look, I got worms. And then as soon as they started moving, you're like, nope.
Not for me, but then.
But Jinx, buy me a drink.
Oh! I can't say anything.
You can't.
I want to buy you wine. I do. Here, let me order you some wine.
just Uber it to me. You know, that's how it works. Okay. Good story, though. I mean, worms, no, did not need to be anywhere near my food or in my refrigerator. I don't ever understand that.
And I don't want my dad to be eating night crawlers either. That's not
nutritious.
I don't
think he would. I don't think he would either. Not in real life, but still weird. Still weird. Thanks. Brett, Michael, Althaus.
How do you remember his middle name?
I have no idea.
I love it, but yes, that's right.
I know your brother's middle name.
I know, that's amazing. You just really blew my mind.
You're welcome. Okay, this next dream comes from Nicole.
Thanks, Nicole.
She starts, I was truly traumatized, but you can laugh. It starts off with, it's a good start, right? Brooke's like dying and you're
I was almost gonna spit that out. Yes. But you can laugh.
You can laugh. Appreciate that.
Thank you.
It starts off with me on a moped in a city that I don't know.
Ooh, the tricky.
Somehow I know I'm supposed to be there because I'm going to visit my best friend at her office.
Okay.
When I get to her office, no one will let me in, and she says I have to have an appointment and turns me away, and I'm devastated.
Her friend says that? Oh, no.
Yep. I tried to find my way back to said moped, which I would never drive in real life.
Right.
To my dismay, it's surrounded by a pack of kids.
Oh, no.
I guess a gang?
Youths?
A gang?
Okay.
Like 8 and 9-year-olds.
Oh, no. I've been scared of a group of 8 or 9-year-olds before on bikes. When I've been walking back to an apartment, like, I don't trust this
group of
kids.
No, you don't trust those little shits. You don't trust the shit, little shits.
They're doing weird stuff. I'm like, no, not for me.
Well, Nicole, she says, I'm not scared of this gang.
Oh.
So I decide to approach thinking, surely, they would not want nothing to do with me, a fluffy, middle-aged white lady.
Fluffy.
I was wrong.
What did they do?
They had babies in baskets. At knife point. And they were forcing me to take some.
I didn't mean to laugh at that. I was just thinking about babies and, like, their baskets.
They told me I had to take 2, 3. I don't know. They were strapping them to the moped.
2, 3, 10, however many you
And
can...
all I could do was cry and scream and beg them not to do it at knife point. And then I woke up in tears.
That's a lot of babies to take.
Why were these babies selling babies and strapping them to your moped?
I don't understand what the profit is. Where are they finding this many babies that they can give 3 to 1 person?
That's a lot of just
and
like black market
shit. They're
selling
the babies.
They're just giving them away.
Giving them away. This is not a good business plan.
That is an insane dream. Nicole, that is a weird, weird dream.
I know, but I loved it.
But I do love it. The fact that she's like, I wouldn't ride a moped, first of all. Second of all, why would kids mess with a middle-aged,
fluffy white woman?
Fluffy
white woman. I love this dream. I did.
That's one of my favorites.
It's
Thank
a good
you, Nicole.
One. Thanks, Nicole. I have another one.
Please.
This is Josh, and he's from Texas.
Yay, Texas.
Texas.
I grounded my son for breaking the head off my daughter's Barbie.
Yeah.
Happened. You were both like,
yeah. I don't have brothers, but I had sisters that did the same.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. Yeah. It's
not
just
cool.
Hurtful. It's just hurtful.
They just pop on and off, though.
Ooh, but, you know, it still hurts.
You take it so personally.
I know. It's like, what?
Barbie. She killed Barbie.
My brother never. I loved Barbie. And I never. My brother loved G.I. Joe. And he wouldn't let me play with him because they weren't the same size. And I'm like, can we be creative, please? I mean, not as a kid, I was thinking that, but I'm like, why can't we play?
Why were G.I. Joe so tiny?
I don't know. And they had like Barbie sized ones of back in the day or now. And
I mean, that could have been like a really nice romantic relationship.
It could have been.
He goes off to war. She finds Ken. Mm-hmm. I mean, it could have been it a
sounds
whole.
Sounds kind of like a
sounds
sexy
like
romance.
Real Housewives to me. I don't know.
Well, he wouldn't let me play. But anyway, I'm not thinking about that anymore, just so you know, even though I'm still talking about it from childhood.
No.
Anyway, so his son breaks the head off his daughter's Barbie. Mm-hmm. I made him go outside and start raking leaves.
Get it?
Fine. I checked on him about 15 minutes later, just looking out the window. I was startled because there was a woman speaking to him. This was my backyard, so there'd be no reason for someone to be back there with him.
Nope.
So again, parents worrying about their children, which they should. In addition, she was super tall, stunningly beautiful, and she was in this hot pink mini dress.
She's a witch. She's Barbie. She is Barbie.
All of this also felt out of place. Very concerned, I opened the back door to go out and see what was going on, only to see this woman grab my son and rip his head off.
No.
Uh-huh.
Barbie.
Uh-huh.
Why?
I dropped to my knees in horror as the woman turned towards me. I could now see so clearly. I knew it was Barbie.
Oh, I thought it was Barbie. I nailed
it. You got it right. A real life-sized Barbie.
No, a real life psycho Barbie.
Yes, a psycho
that
Barbie?
That would kill.
What do you think she would wear? Psycho Barbie. What's she got on?
She's got definitely a garter belt with a knife.
And a straight jacket. A straight jacket and a garter belt.
Straight jacket Barbie. Yeah,
she's got heels on. She always has to have heels.
Oh, she's got heels. Of course she has heels. Wow. Because she can do shit in heels, but you don't have to be rude and like.
Don't rip a kid's head off.
Rip off a kid's head.
I mean, I get that he ripped the head off the Barbie.
It was like a revenge thing.
Revenge thing, but this is a real life human child. I'm sorry, Josh. I, one, hope your son's okay. And two, hope he learned a lesson from your dream and doesn't rip the heads off your daughter's Barbies anymore.
My jaw is open because that is like so, so high level.
Instant karma.
Instant karma.
That is right there.
God damn, Barbie.
Oh,
evil Barbies. Josh, don't even. It's like right there next to clowns. Evil Barbies. Clowns.
I mean, they are kind of creepy if they're evil, if you think about it. Ooh, Barbies and clowns.
All right. Well, I've got one more for you, but this is more of a story, a dream story. Okay.
I'm into it.
This is a little bit true crimey, so hold on to your butt.
Hold on to your butts.
And buckle up. Hold on to your butt and buckle up. It sounds like it could be a t-shirt.
Thank you. I thought it could be a t-shirt too. That's why I was laughing.
Okay. This one comes from Morgan. And Morgan is from Texas.
Oh, another Texas.
Oh, Texans. We love you our crazy Texans.
Yay.
Hi. I used to have reoccurring nightmares after the store I worked at was robbed.
Oh, no.
The dreams were always similar. Okay. A man coming into my room with what looked like a rifle hanging from his hand.
No.
Or a man standing a few inches above me, gun drawn.
No, I don't like it.
I would freak, gasp, and sit up after these dreams, and it always scared the shit out of my husband. It was really bad.
Yeah.
So, of course, I go, Morgan, tell me more.
Right? Of course. Like, we need more.
You're burying the lead on this.
dig deeper into your
pain. What the hell happened to you when you got held up when you were working?
I want to know too.
So we got a little bit more of the story, which I absolutely love. Thank you, Morgan, for sending this in.
Yes, thank you for following up. We appreciate it.
As for the story, I was 20 years old and working in a jewelry store in a small city mall. It could have been like K Jewelers.
K Jewelers, every kiss begins
with
K.
Killer. Okay.
Oh!
I was 20 years old.
Begins with K.
I was 20 years old working in a jewelry store in a small city mall.
Okay.
I opened that morning with my coworker. And right as we opened the gates, I decided to go to the bathroom since we usually had a rush a few minutes after opening.
Yeah.
I had my case keys with me and took them to the back. I took them off in our break room and laid them on the counter because the idea of taking them to the bathroom just grossed me out.
Okay, well,
understand.
I get that part. Like, maybe you leave your water bottle outside.
Yeah.
But
no, I get it. Don't bring keys. They're important, but don't. Yeah, I understand the point that, like, don't bring in things that other people are going to touch into the bathroom. Okay. During the 3 minutes I was in the bathroom.
Oh, 3 minutes. Very specific.
My coworker had a weirdo lady come in.
Of course.
And ask about an expensive ring.
Mm.
He was weirded out by her. Turns out she was distracting him so her friend could go into the break room, big dude, and steal my keys. Cleaned out our solitaires and stole $67,000 in under 3 minutes.
$67,000.
He pocketed my keys with my name on them.
This is definitely not Hot Topic.
When I couldn't find my keys and we found the case a mess, we realized we'd been robbed.
Yeah.
We watched the security footage and saw him follow me into the back about 30 seconds after I walked
creepy.
Back there.
Creepy. Oh, super creepy.
The cop said if I had come out of the bathroom, he would have likely shot me because they were definitely armed. This messed me up so bad. I never saw the man or the gun with my own eyes, but I didn't need to. It was a violation of the place I had previously felt secure.
Of course.
2 years ago, when I went back.
Oh, my God.
To the same mall.
Mm-hmm.
We had an active shooter situation.
Shut the fuck up.
We all hid and watched the SWAT team swarm the place. This time I was pregnant. The stress caused me to start having contractions and spotting at 25 weeks.
Oh, no.
Luckily, this time it was just a hoax.
But it still created the stress in your body.
Needless to say, I no longer work there. After some therapy, I stopped having these dreams. Now, unless I'm under a lot of stress, I'm totally good.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Morgan,
that's terrible.
Could you? Oh, my God.
You
imagine.
That she was telling a real story. Like you.
So she has this recurring dream of her, this dude coming into her bedroom at night and holding a gun to her face or
and
holding
she
a rifle.
Really experienced.
And she experienced such
a close
trauma.
Encounter. Oh, Morgan. Oh, my God. Well, I'm glad you've used the benefit of therapy to help you.
Absolutely.
It's really a lifesaver for anyone.
And luckily you have your husband there when you wake up yes. and you have these freaking dreams and you stress out and he's there to comfort you and you have this beautiful baby now, this child. I mean, that's like the best thing. But my God, I'm so glad you don't work there anymore, by the way.
Me too.
Leave that job. It's too much stress. Too much stress. Well, that, I think, wraps up listener dreams.
Ooh, thank you.
Oh,
that
my God.
That was intense. That was a
we
good
had
one.
A lot of different kinds of dreams
it
we
was
had.
Like a grab bag tonight.
Funny.
Like,
we had dream story of crazy robberies and we had
real life stuff. Yeah.
Crazy.
Oh, it was a good one.
Don't forget, if you want to support the show, you can go to remelations.com/support if you're having a great time tonight. Hey, and we're announcing a new giveaway. Are you ready for this? The Tag Your Bestie contest.
It's starting.
It's starting now. And since we're coming up on a year of doing this podcast, we're giving away an amazing swag bag. Yeah, swag. I use the word swag bag.
I love swag bag.
To a pair of besties. Yeah, the other half of your best friend necklace. We want you to tag your bestie. So any social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, just at Remelations and tag your bestie.
Yes.
Every friend you, if you have multiple friends, you can totally tag each and every one of your besties.
All of them.
And we're going to have an amazing gift bag for you because we're coming out with merch this month. And you're going to get some amazing swag. So don't forget to tag your bestie and enter the contest.
This is the contest to enter, peeps. It really is.
Woo!
Ah, I stole your woo twice. My woo again.
Do it. Do it. Do it.
All right. Okay, so I've got a really interesting story to talk about today, and you may have heard of it. I don't know yet. It's pretty new. So I know, including ourselves, we have a lot of true crime lovers out there, too.
Yes.
So this article is from the Des Moines Register.
Local to Iowa. Des Moines.
Des Moines.
It's so funny because I heard somewhere, like, it's called Des Moines.
Right.
But in Chicago, it's called Des Plaines.
Yes, that is weird, isn't it?
How does that work? Spelled the same way.
Hmm.
Do you have a des around you?
Yeah, how does it work? DES around you? Tell us how you pronounce it.
How do you pronounce it? Because there seems to be some controversy on that.
Yeah, well.
Des.
I don't know. I was very French, actually. We've got Dubuque, Des Moines. That's it.
But Des Plaines?
Des Plaines.
Or my dad calls it Des Moines. It's fine.
Does he? Oh, I love
Well, he say I will wash the dishes. So.
Oh, he's a washer. Yeah,
he's a washer. Gotta wash the laundry and wash the dishes.
We've got washers around here. We sure do.
We do. But please.
Okay. So the title, though, is Investigation Underway into Daughter's Allegation of Iowa Man Was Prolific Serial Killer.
Oh my God. Yes, I've heard this. This is crazy. We don't know that much, right?
No, because it just started. So according to his daughter, Donald Dean Studdy, I don't know if it's Studdy or Studdy, murdered 5 to 6 women a year for decades.
Which would put him up there with the most prolific serial killers of all time.
Seriously, up there. Okay, I was going to say, so currently the two most prolific serial killers on record are Samuel Little.
Yes.
Tied to 60 murders, but confessed to 93.
Yeah, no.
No, that's a lot. Awful, and Gary Ridgway, the Green River Killer, tied to 49 murders, but confessed to 60, suspected to be more than 70.
Can you imagine just like having this mental checklist of people you've killed?
How do you kill 70? People.
And then you're like, oh yeah, she was the girl in the red dress, or oh yeah, that was the one with the brunette hair.
I never understand when people are like, yes, I remember exactly where I buried her or where I dropped her, you know. It's,
but to them, that's like, to serial killers, and this is just my opinion,
yeah,
it is such a crime of self-boasting or self-worth, or you know, you're getting something back from it that it does make sense for you to keep a mental. It's like a life moment for you.
But
almost.
Can you remember even 93 people? Like Samuel Little confessed to 93. Can you even name 93 people, let alone where they're buried and where you drop their bodies? It's
insane.
It's crazy. Sick. It is. So the police are actively looking into it, but you know, there's it's just really the daughter's.
And this isn't like Western Iowa, right? Like, yes, near like Omaha area.
So it's, I think they said 40 miles or something. I can't remember from Omaha. So very close. It's on the western border of Iowa.
But talk about like finding the people that are like most disenfranchised, people that don't notice people missing, right? You go for the sex workers and
that's what I was going to say. It's, you know, like most serial killers, the women were mostly sex workers or runaways.
Yeah.
And that's like the same thing, especially Gary Ridgway, you know, that's like all he did was pick up sex workers. And I mean, because there's no one looking for them, sadly.
Sadly.
It's like but okay, so the police did listen to the daughter and at least bring cadaver dogs out to his property.
Yeah.
And there were hits of decomposing remains. And the daughter said it was in this super deep well, like 90 feet, 100 feet. And she even said, like, the kids, I don't know how many brothers and sisters she has had to help, like,
that
dispose.
Is sick.
And now she's saying this, and like another sister is saying, no, that never happened. So it's just this very interesting story.
That's still developing.
Just in its infancy. Yeah, just in its infancy. He died, though, in 2013, but he lived on that same property until his death. And The daughter said he mostly made his living off smuggling guns and drugs. So it wasn't like he was this stand-up guy in general. But, I mean, they think approximately 70 women, which, again, would be right up there in the top for U.S. Right. For U.S. serial killers. That
this is not like a number you want to, it's not like a goal you want to shoot for. No. I'm sorry. If you do, you're insane.
No. I mean, you shouldn't kill one person, let alone 70.
Can you, God. No, it's very stressing to think about this. Yeah. And I'm not sure if you're familiar with the detective Paul Holes.
Yes.
Worked on the case of the Golden State Killer.
Yes.
Has a podcast called Barry Bones right now. Mm-hmm. And he just recently said in this podcast that cadaver dogs are just one way of getting to information. Like, it doesn't mean it's like actually true, and we don't know that about this case yet.
Right.
But it is an indication that perhaps this is where you should look for things.
Decomposing remains.
Yeah. That bothers me. That whole story bothers me, and I'm interested to see where it goes in the next few weeks.
I know. Hopefully we'll learn some more, but man, it's weird to get into a new true crime story, like nowadays, like that prolific. Like, we could possibly be on the tail of a story of the most prolific serial killer in U.S. history.
And not like, even known.
And not even known. Ugh, we're just sickening. Finding, I mean, he died in 2013. He's been
good.
Dead 10
he
years.
Should have died like yes, 50 die, years ago.
Die. But my God, like, we're just learning about this. It's like.
Did you hear that they just recently had a announcement about the Delphi murders?
Oh.
The two girls in Indiana who are walking on that trail in Delphi, yes. Indiana. And they arrested someone about this case.
Oh, good. I didn't hear about
that's
that.
That's one of the cases that probably terrified me as a mom the most because it's recent.
It is.
And I have kids that age. And it was a video on Snapchat. The sweet baby girl had posted of this guy walking towards them, and that just kills me. And the fact that they haven't arrested the case, good.
I hope it sticks. I hope they got who it is.
They have the evidence, convict.
And that it's the right person.
The rest of your life.
Disgusting. Oh my God, just horrifying. I can't even imagine being a parent and having that terror, that fear. Oh my God.
Yeah, it is not great.
But it is really interesting that this is all unfolding in front of us, like in real time.
Yeah. Can't wait to hear more. And hopefully, if it is true, that at least some families can get some closure on what happened to their loved ones.
Even, could you imagine if the daughter even made it up and the other daughter is correct? Like, there's so much drama. Like, is it real? Is one sister lying against the other sister? Like, there's a lot going on.
There's still a lot to be unraveled in this one. But yes, exactly. I agree. Interesting case for sure.
Oh, boy.
You can put your glasses
on. I don't need them. I just didn't want. I didn't have makeup on, so I was thinking I could.
You didn't go to work with makeup
I don't
today?
Wear makeup any day.
Oh,
I
really?
I used to, but now
good
I'm
for
like.
You. I know. I usually don't most days
it's like,
either.
Who am I impressing there? I like.
I get it.
Makeup, but it's like now I have no need for it. But
no, I know. I feel bad for my husband.
Do you like it like this?
This is what you get.
Wake
the rest
up
of your life.
And see it.
I remember when Mark and I first started dating. It was like I felt like I always had like have my face
totally.
On. And, like, you had to have your legs shaved because you never know. Like, when you go over there, what could happen to his house? And whatever. So it's like, now we're married. I'm like, well, he's lucky if he sees me with makeup, like, 10%
well,
of the time.
Well, I also remember, like, when I first met Chad, like, when he was at the bar, I'd be like, put makeup on, go there, like, sit at the end of the bar, like, look all
cute, dressed in something cute.
Like, I tried. Yeah. Now it's like, take me as I am.
See, this or nothing.
Take it or leave it.
I did get an Amazon magazine, like almost like a ad for Christmas, but magazine ad
from Amazon.
Yeah, you don't get this?
I've never seen this before.
Maybe I spent way too much money at Amazon,
or maybe
because
it's
I've gotten
in a bigger city. I don't know.
I've got an Amazon Christmas catalog now.
Wow. I guess I should go check my mail, but I've never gotten one before.
It's got like clothes, it's got like kids toys.
Do you get this every year?
I did get it last year. I think they're making it more of a thing because it was like thicker this year than it was in the past years.
I should check my mail.
You should check your mail. But it doesn't compare to like the Sears catalog when we were
kids. God, that was like 17 pounds and five inches thick.
It sat on the back of the toilet in our powder room downstairs. Good reading. In our big yellow house. Mm-hmm. And I had the marker and I'm just circling everything I want. Like the purple marker's Mindy.
Yep.
The pink marker's Kelly.
Of course.
And then we had it all marked.
Right?
Within a few bathroom
trips.
Were
you like circling the washer and dryer too?
What else do you have to do? You don't have?
You have time to look through the Sears catalog.
You had time in there. You had no cell phone. What are you going to do? Just bring a marker.
Don't you think it would be funny to see what you would circle now as opposed to what you circled then? If Sears was still around.
But I do remember when I was a kid, I used to like go through every... was obviously in the bathroom a lot. I don't know. I remember like going through every page of this thing. I made it a game with myself to point to each page one thing I wanted. I could only pick one on each page.
Love this.
This is like the, I don't know. You're this like, is a page weird 20, confession.
I want E.
It's like a dining room set. I'm like, I would take the chairs. I'm like 10 years old. I want the chairs. I go to page 11 and it'd be like, men's boxers. I'm like, if I was a man, I'd pick the purple ones.
That's next page. Great. You were ahead of your time.
I picked out, it was like a game I played. I was obviously a very, very bored child.
I'm done with my Christmas shopping pretty much, you know, because I don't have like 18,000 gifts to buy.
Mm-hmm.
But I got Chad underwear.
Are they purple?
For Christmas.
No, like, underwear is an absolute must for Christmas.
I mean, it's like the joke gift, but he loves Lacoste. You know, like the polos with like the little alligator.
Little alligator ones,
I got him some little, like four, I think it's a 3-pack or a 5-pack of Lacoste.
Well, good thing it's the first week of November and he doesn't listen to this podcast.
Right, exactly.
It's going to be a surprise.
Oh, yes, yeah, surprise. I mean, I don't think it's a good thing he doesn't listen, but it's a good thing he doesn't listen to this episode.
Get it.
So I told him, I'm like, you know what? You're getting something for Christmas and it's not going to be huge, but I think you'll like it. I think he'll like it.
Of course. I always get Mark underwear every year. I get all my kids' underwear.
For real? Everyone
in this house gets underwear for Christmas every year.
I thought you were totally joking. No.
And they have to open it on Christmas morning.
And hold it
they
up.
Just know. No, they don't have to hold it up. But they just know that's what they're... You need them.
You
might
need
as well
them.
Wrap them up.
Can I put some on my Christmas list and you can get me a couple?
I will. Can just let me know what brand you like. I'm going to wrap them up and put them in your stocking. Great. If you wrap them up individually, more presents to open.
Oh, my God. Maybe I should open, because I got it already. It came. Maybe I should open and wrap, like, five different pairs of underwear.
And then wrap them in one. So you wrap the five individual wrappings in one wrapping, and it's, like, six gifts in one.
And then it's, like, one of those Russian nesting dolls.
Nesting dolls, yeah.
Love this
underwear
idea.
Upon underwear upon underwear.
You like it? Open the next one. Guess what?
Ooh, this one's
you like
green.
That one? Open the next, one. I don't know. I feel like he'll like it. He's not a gift person anyway. Like, that's definitely not his love language. He knows it's mine.
Mm-hmm.
But it's one of mine, like physical and gift giving. But I'm a gift giver. That is my love language. So it's very like difficult. To be with someone that doesn't want gifts.
Yeah.
Because I like the giving part and I like the reaction.
That's so funny because Mark and I, neither of us are gifts are high up at all.
Yeah.
Like both very bottom of our lists. So for us, like it's quality time and touch.
Yeah.
Like, that's it. But
we don't have the option for that. So maybe it'll be quality time and touch. It's definitely. That's definitely for him. And that's definitely I don't know. I like all the love languages. It's
look,
just,
I like all the love.
I like all
I
the
love.
I
love
love. My problem, it's really hard when your love language is to give and the person you want is like.
Doesn't care.
So like I have to like adjust.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's part of being in a relationship.
It is, but...
This is a relationship hour with Mindy and Brooke, our next podcast.
Tell us your relationship needs, problems.
Call 1-800...
Relationship? That's way too
many. That sounds about right.
It could be right. Just you don't need the S-H-I-P part. No, I don't know how many letters.
It's just a relationship.
1-800-RELATIONSHIP. That's our next podcast. Relationship.
My God. Tell me what you thought about the latest Halloween movie. Oh, okay, I saw your Facebook post. And I think if I could quote it correctly, it said, Halloween did me dirty.
Halloween done did me dirty.
Done did me dirty.
You are correct.
And it's funny because my youngest twin, she went to it a couple weeks ago and she said, it's awful. And, okay. And I'm like, okay. And Brooke's going into it, you know, this week. And I said, she's a huge Halloween fan. Mm-hmm. So let's see what she thinks. And not so good, huh?
Not so great. I almost don't even want to talk about it. It's so heartbreaking because obviously I've grown up with this franchise. It means a lot to me. It's something that I named my cat Haddonfield. Like, this is a big deal. And for this to end, like, after 40 years was heartbreaking enough. But then to make this piece of crap, oh, I'm going to get into
it. I couldn't wait to this rant. Yeah. I've been waiting all week.
This piece of crap movie. Not only was it one of the worst movies I've ever seen, but to end the franchise like this?
There's no way they can end it on this, it sounds
like. It's terrible. I don't want to, like, give away any spoilers in case people are seeing it, but, like, heartbreaking to me. Like, I went with Chad, friend Chad, my brother. Like, we were all in. We saw the other two together, like, of this this newest trilogy. Same directors, same writers. The first two, great.
Good.
What went wrong?
So they fell asleep?
Someone did more than fall asleep. This was a piece of crap. And it breaks my heart to say it. It does. But I was so disappointed. And, like, we just kept sitting there like...
mouths open. Cannot believe it's this shitty.
Like, all three of us, like, because we're all super fans. Like, what are they... What? That's kind of like what it was, basically. Just, what?
Why?
I don't know what happened, but it was horrible. And like I said, just not even from the franchise standpoint, as a movie, standalone movie.
Just standalone. Not
terrible.
Great.
I don't know what they were trying to do.
Yeah. It's like the Lifetime movie Mark and I watched last night. It was just horrible.
Oh, man. What was it? Like, my brother is my stepmom?
See, it was, no, it was a killer PTA mom.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. And
they always have crazy twists on those Lifetime movies.
You know, moved to a new city, joined the PTA, and there's another PTA mom that just wants to kill all the good PTA moms. And,
well, you know,
it sounds about
thing.
On that level, right?
Yeah.
Just awful. It's just all around awful.
Sorry. It's just so upsetting. I can't do anything but laugh.
Okay. Well, I'll change the subject. Speaking of shows.
Yes.
Okay, if you don't know us tonight, I've got this t-shirt on.
What does it say?
Can you read it?
Don't make me go, Beth Dunn on you. And then was Yellowstone?
Yeah.
Oh, that's your show.
That's my show. So Yellowstone, we just finished the season finale of season 4 because we've just been catching up.
I love how you have a shirt on and you're like, I have to show
you. I have to show you my shirt.
My shirt.
I found this at Maurice's, by the way.
Oh! Maurice. Maurice's needs to sponsor the show, I feel
like.
Yeah,
they do. Yeah. So I found this shirt. And if you know... if you're a fan of Yellowstone, you know, Beth Dutton's like this scorched earth crazy bitch that will do anything to protect her family. And she will fuck over anyone.
Don't fuck anytime. With Beth.
Don't fuck with Beth. And so I have this shirt to represent. Season premiere of Yellowstone is like in a week and a half from now. It's like November 13th.
Cannot wait. Oh my God. What season?
But Kevin Costner, my God. Ugh. This is the last, I think this is the last season, season 5.
My God, if they fucking done do you dirty. Like
they don't do, they better not do me dirty on this.
They better not do you dirty on this.
Mr. Costner, Kevin, don't do me dirty on this.
Kev,
baby.
Come on, baby. Let's just get on the same page. Oh my God, I'm excited
for that.
There's nothing like the feeling of a season premiere or even like a season finale or a series finale.
I know, you just got all that anticipation. I totally get it. And then to be done dirty.
I don't think Yellowstone's going to do it to you. I don't.
I hope not.
I'm praying that it doesn't. Because it's a terrible feeling.
Well, it's like the Game of Thrones. The end. You ever watch Game of Thrones or no? Okay, no. Okay.
Not
Game
yet.
Of Thrones, like the end of Game of Thrones just was so rushed. And it's like, oh, it could have been so good. If you drug it out like one more season, you could have wrapped it all up all perfectly, but you didn't.
I feel like that's a big part of why I haven't gotten into it. Because I've heard such, it's like if someone had told you, the last episode of The Sopranos is stupid. Like, would you still watch it? Like, I don't know.
No one's ever going to be completely happy with an ending.
No, and it's like the last episode they of won't. Seinfeld, which I am a huge fan of, but it sucked.
Like, or Friends or anything else.
Anything. Like,
you're always going to be disappointed. You're always going to have your critics.
I mean, there's good parts and bad parts, of course, but it's like, oh, that's so painful. I think Kev's not going to do that to
Kev's
you.
Not going to do me.
No, there's no way.
No, he ain't.
Although, I will say, I didn't think Jamie Lee Curtis could do that to me, but she sure as fuck did. I don't blame her, though. Jamie's been with us since the jump. God bless her.
He's still after
the original Scream Queen.
Yeah, original.
She's amazing. I'm not mad at her, but I am mad at the movie.
Well, I mean, speaking of being disappointed, thanks for listening to our podcast.
Why would you say speaking of being disappointed?
Just kidding. Not really.
Opposite of being disappointed.
The opposite of being disappointed is listening to this podcast.
Exactly.
And if Thank you enjoyed God. It, you know what? You could tell your best friend about the show. Tell them, you know what? We never let you down and never did you dirty.
We like never Halloween. Done do you dirty.
We never did do you dirty.
We won't That's right. ever either. Promise.
We won't.
Pinky swear.
Pinky swear. And if you tell one of your best friends about the show, that just helps us. And we would greatly appreciate that. You can also tell your favorite clown that stands 1 inch from your face after you stab him and punch him in the face.
Punch him in the baby maker.
Tell your favorite fluffy middle-aged white lady.
Mm-hmm.
Don't forget about that. And tell your favorite jewelry store employee not to get robbed.
Yeah.
And go to therapy like our friend did.
Keep your keys on you.
Yeah, keep your keys on you. Even if they're dirty in the bathroom, keep your keys on you. Lock
Sometimes
the door.
It's for the best.
Lock the door.
Yes.
But don't forget to tell them about the podcast because that's how we grow and that's how we keep coming back each and every week to you, besties. And we appreciate each and every one of you.
We love you. Thank you. Thank you to all of our listeners and dream submissions. Oh, it was so great this week. Really good mix. Really good mix.
A lot of different things.
We were on a roller coaster ride. So yeah, thank you so much for submitting your dream stories and dreams. Good stuff.
All right, bestie. Don't forget to tune in next week where we read more listener dreams and give our, what'd you say, non-expertise?
Yeah, very
Our very loose interpretation of what we think they mean. So tune in next week. We love you, bestie. But until then, sweet dreams, bitches.
I love it. It loves it.
It loves it. You loves it. It's the fastest.